Got a very interesting article here that a brother sent to me. I've been wanting to make a video about this, just haven't gotten around to doing it yet. But just very telling. I have come out against John Ronald Reuel Tolkien, J.R.R. Tolkien. His Lord of the Rings series was just basically taking pagan principles and introducing it and making it popular for the public. Before Tolkien and C.S. Lewis came out with their works, C.S. Lewis, The Chronicles of Narnia, Tolkien, The Lord of the Rings, before they came out with that, witchcraft and the sorcery and the occult were really not mainstream. These two men were the ones who introduced it to the mainstream. Very, very wicked. But something that a lot of people didn't know, and I myself did not know this, here's the article. I'll show it on screen. C.S. Lewis was a secret government agent. This is Christianity Today, which I have some issues with that organization, but the point is, you can get down through and read this thing. We're not going to read the whole thing here, but it goes into saying about how that he worked. C.S. Lewis began his wartime service by undertaking a mission for MI6, British Military Intelligence there. That's what the MI stands for, Military Intelligence. And essentially, what they were doing is they were trying to, when you get into the article, like I said, we're not going to get into it. You can read the article. I'll put the link in the description box. But what they were trying to do is they were trying to get to people and put propaganda out there to make people, I think it was the Norwegians, to make them feel like the British were interested in their culture and everything, which a lot of the, again, a lot of the Lord of the Rings mythology, especially, Tolkien was an expert on a lot of the Icelandic Norwegian myths. And C.S. Lewis was reading stories and things like this, working for military intelligence, excuse me. Incredible, absolutely incredible. And of course, these guys were also members of different secret societies, and so it's just like incredible. And yet, a lot of people still think that C.S. Lewis is some kind of a hero of the faith. He's not. Doug Stauffer has a good book out on that, Dr. Doug Stauffer, about the Chronicles of Narnia, the whole C.S. Lewis thing. I mean, just to give you just a little bit of a basic thing that should kind of scare you off if you're a Christian, is the Chronicles of Narnia. You have Lucy, I think it is. Well, it was read to me when I was a boy. But Lucy, the one girl, I think it's Lucy, she is led around by Mr. Tumis. And what is he? He's a satyr. He's a half man, half goat. And you look at the description, you draw it out, it's like a description of the popular depiction of Satan. And this is her guide to take her through the land of Narnia. So, big problem. But again, very interesting. And you say, well, that was back then over in England, that were during World War II, they had to do those things. That doesn't happen anymore. Well, no, I don't think so. You see, the military branch here in America, my wife knows about this. She was telling me about this. U.S. Army Civil Affairs and Psychological Operations Command. It's a CAPOC, USA CAPOC, CAPOC. That's another one that you need to watch out for. And that's a lot of the special forces, special ops types of guys, they get into that. And they'll go into a country, they'll start to disseminate propaganda. And there was a guy here on YouTube, and he boldly was just wearing hats with CAPOC type symbols. YouTube channel was Main Prepper. And he took his channel down. He was having some mental problems or something, and but there's a lot of that stuff on YouTube. You get into some of the prepper stuff and everything. These guys are former military, quote unquote former military. You're dealing with the psychological operations type of stuff. I'm just saying that's be very careful about some of that stuff. But just really fascinating to see that C.S. Lewis was working with military intelligence. Really something.